Well, more media jobs are on the chopping block tonight after News Limited unveiled its digital restructure plans. Unlike its rival Fairfax, though, it's not giving away any figures on potential redundancies. Chief Executive Kim Williams says that would be reckless. Staff now face an anxious wait to see if they'll survive. Eddie Meyer reports.
We cannot say today how many positions will be made redundant, as it will take time to roll out the new model.
Certainly a lot of changes, but not at this stage, according to what we're told, wholesale slash and burn.
For those in the media, this is becoming a familiar refrain. Tough times require tough action. Rebuilding News Limited will mean restructuring, and that's code for job cuts. 1,000 possibly out of a workforce of 8,000, unions are maintaining a brave face.
We welcome in the current environment anyone saying they have a continuing commitment to print.
To cut costs, operations will be streamlined and three quarters of its East Coast division shut.
We will adopt a one city, one newsroom strategy across our daily, Sunday and community products.
But News also revealed a big play, one that could provide substantial revenue. It's bid $2 billion for James Packer's Consolidated Media, picking up its pay TV assets, taking its share of Foxtel to 50%. It's also bought a lucrative business news website and its 16,000 subscribers. On the back of news that Fairfax would slash almost 2,000 jobs and that Gina Rinehart had increased her control, there were tough questions today for the communications minister. He believes the mining magnate's decision not to sign a charter of editorial independence is nothing short of a brand trashing exercise.
She's been very clear. She wants the right to hire and fire the editor. This will cause a readership crisis of confidence.
Change, it seems, will be painful in the new digital world.
So what does this mean for Australia's media landscape? Joining me now is journalist and shareholder activist Stephen Mayne. Thanks very much for your time tonight. I know you like to take a dig at the big media owners at any opportunity, but you actually think that this was the right decision today?
Well, I mean, all newspaper print media companies all over the world are having to deal with the crisis of revenue going onto the internet. So you just can't stop the inevitable. It was nowhere near as dramatic as what Fairfax did. You didn't have, you know, 150-year-old broadsheets suddenly become tabloids and printing plants being closed. But you did basically have a fairly major internal restructure to be rolled out over
Stephen,
the next
could the
2 years.
Stephen, could the numbers of people losing jobs be similar to that of Fairfax? Because Kim Williams just hasn't put a figure on it.
Well, there's 8,000 News Limited staff. I think probably they'll lose around about 1,000 over the next 2 years. But they're not closing any big printing plants. All they're doing is sort of creating five big divisions where the one management team and editorial team will run seven-day newspapers and all the suburban newspapers. And they'll put all the digital internet operations with that. So, look, it's going to be bruising. But at the end of the day, News Corp's a $50 billion company with lots of cash. They're not in the same crisis that Fairfax is with a Gina Rinehart trying to take them over.
Have you ever seen a week like this in the Australian print media?
Oh, no, look, it's absolutely unbelievable. I mean, broadsheets of 150 years disappearing, printing presses that are only 10 years old in Melbourne being shut down, four generations of the Packer family getting out of their big media investments, and that was the really big story today, was James Packer saying, thank you, Mr. Murdoch, for $1 billion, I'm getting out of pay TV so I can become the king of casinos in Australia. So to have all of these developments happening in the same week with Gina Rinehart, worth $29 billion, trying to buy our most venerable and independent media house in Fairfax. I mean, the media is being turned on its head.
All right, Stephen Mayne, we'll leave it there. Thanks for your time tonight.
Thanks, Hamish.